Welcome to Sense the Podcast, where we talk about real issues, real solutions. My name is Saitabao Kaiyare.
And I'm Carlos Lawson.
And I'm Anastacia Waweru.
Today's topic, we'll be talking about celebrities. What about celebrities? So actually, first of all, let's define a celebrity. Who is a celebrity in your own perspective?
In my perspective, I think a celebrity is someone who has a large number of following, you can say, and a person who has a lot of influence on people.
Okay. And what about you?
A celebrity is a person who, perhaps through his or her profession, brings out some issues or is focused on one specific thing. Mm-hmm. He could be a writer, musician, photographer. Mm-hmm. So.
Basically, in the entertainment industry.
Basically, a person who is famous will be doing something or accomplishing something.
Be someone who has attracted public attention because of what they do.
Someone who's got a public image in society.
A well-known person, and most of the time they're well-known because they've been accorded so much attention in the media.
I would also go a little further and feel that a celebrity can also be an animal.
Yeah. So I of late, you know, we have social media, we have, you know, all this media out there, and sometimes we get to see our celebrities, especially, you know, sometimes African celebrities doing various publicity stunts. Some are good, some are not good. Some are morally right, others are not. And the question is, the issue here is, how far is too far? What are the lengths a celebrity is willing to go to?
Well, as I said before, a celebrity has to have a large following. Mm-hmm. And I think especially in our culture in Africa, we've adapted that. Mm-hmm. So for them, anything they can do that can get people's attention, that can get you likes on Facebook, on Instagram, they'll do it. Mm-hmm. I don't think for them there's any limit.
Okay.
I believe it's the fake it till you make it mindset. Mm-hmm. And that's the poison that's killing everyone. Mm. So you don't really have the funds or resources, but you will pretend that you have it online, and then one thing leads to another, exposes, scandals, mm-hmm. you refute the claims, and the cycle just goes on.
It goes on. But the question is, are they good role models to our societies, our generation? Because, you know, at the end of the day, people are looking up to them. You know, people aspire, dream of being them. Mm-hmm. So, and are they being good role models to us, especially the younger generations, and, you know, to society as well?
I think it depends on how you look at it, because everyone has their good and bad side. Mm-hmm. But for celebrities, they tend to lean on the so-called immoral side, mm-hmm. because, as we said, they're trying to get the attention of people, they're trying to get following, and they're trying to follow trends and, you know, post all this kind of stuff, especially to show, like, maybe they have a lot of money and all that. As in, so they'd go to those extents. But I think, at the end, you know, these are people who follow their dreams. These are people who've gone to certain lengths to get where they are, and it's not been easy. So it depends on how you look at it.
But I feel they're not doing their job. Especially, I feel most majority of the, I'd say 90% are not good role models. I don't know, do you agree with me? 90%. Actually, 95% of celebrities are not good role models. Honestly, that's my perspective. I don't know, what do you think?
I think in the beginning you start off humble, you have your purpose right, but as things go on, you start to lose yourself within the whole money, fame, groupies, writers, publicists coming to you for interviews.
Yeah.
So basically, it's just you lose your grounding.
You become consumed.
Yeah, you dive in and you don't know how to swim out.
Yeah, there's no getting out.
Depending on the type of celebrity and maybe how they sell themselves or what people are looking for in them, the impact can be either positive or negative.
Like, let's say the politician. I would really aspire to be a women rep just because of Shebesh, how she behaves. Yeah, I admire her.
I know so many people would have wanted to copy her. As for instance, you see somebody like David Beckham, this footballer. You hear so many little children running, and then they would just call, "I am David Beckham. I am so and so. I am so and so." So, you know, those ones would aspire to excel in that field. Others also would want to do it, especially in politics. Like in Kenya, you know, Sonko, when you mention about Sonko in town, then you feel that there's somebody who, in the politics, is a name that you may not fail to mention because of his popularity and also others as well.
Good role models and they're bad ones, because there's some of them that have positive impacts, like whatever they do, whatever they say, be it soccer, be it rugby, be it music, be it whatever the profession they're into. Some people actually get positive things from that, but then there are others who are on the other extreme end, which is not such a good thing, but we don't judge.
Sad.
Yeah, it's sad because especially, you know, the biggest problem is we see all these celebrities out there. They're always, you know, probably half posting semi-nude photos or nude photos. Well, there's nothing against that, you know. Well, it's
are
how
you
they
sure?
feel. Well, I don't think you know.
Someone
what do you
likes,
mean by
likes that?
Yeah, but according to our society, what do you mean there's nothing against
no, but
that?
You see, they're expressing themselves, and you know we have freedom of expression. So if probably they express themselves by being nude, who are we to judge, you know? But the question is, you know, at the end of the day, us as a society, we always like controversy things, like controversial things, like, you know, let's say nude photos of a celebrity.
Yeah.
Because, you know, that will get the results.
Yeah.
So how do we address such an issue?
I don't know. It goes a long way because it starts even with media.
Mm-hmm.
Because the media is going to give that attention.
Yeah.
And if you don't, I feel like for a celebrity, if you don't do that,
mm-hmm.
you won't make it.
Yeah.
It's a bad mentality, but that's what
question is, do you have to do that so that you can make it?
But how else are you going to get the attention of the media?
Well, there are so many other ways, don't you think so? I feel there are so many other ways.
Very little times will you see, you know, this musician donated this money to these children.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time, as you're saying, it's going to be a scandal.
A scandal.
Yeah.
Or a beef or a feud.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
And even those beefs, like how do you know they're not stage managed? You know,
that's,
so-and-so is having beef with so-and-so and they're fighting
yeah.
on or, you know, Twitter or Instagram.
It's
or
just
whatever.
A publicity
yeah.
stunt. Yeah.
yeah.
True.
Yeah. So, and actually, Carlos here happens to be a DJ, so he has quite some experience with celebrities.
I wouldn't say experience.
Well, you've interacted with them, you know, quite, especially African celebrities.
Here in Kenya, I think Julie Gishuru is a celebrity because we know her very well.
Okay, like a musician and also a
dancer. Nelson Mandela.
Back in the day, Muhammad, he was one of the best photographers Kenya has ever produced.
How would you tell us your experience was or the interaction? What do you think of them? Do you think they carry themselves well? Are they snobbish? Are they arrogant? You know, all those negative things
uh-huh.
that
yeah.
we always hear about celebrities. Oh, they're this and that. So, what's your experience like?
I've met my fair share of those who are grounded and those who, I would say, lost themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think it's because you love the attention.
Mm-hmm.
And
you love the fame.
You love the groupies. Like the group is the biggest disease. biggest,
the
I mean,
biggest,
is
yeah.
The, like when I DJ at parties, and yes, I meet some people who want to take photos and such. It's a good feeling,
mm-hmm.
but you also need to remember you're there as a profession.
Mm-hmm.
So you're there to provide a service.
Mm-hmm.
You provide your service, you leave.
Okay.
Nothing else needs to happen.
So you have to not be consumed,
mm-hmm.
you know, by fame. Because, you know, fame is it's a very dangerous thing.
It also comes down to, you have to remember, why did you start doing what you're doing?
Yeah.
Where did you start being a DJ? Where did you start being a musician, a
mm-hmm.
producer,
mm-hmm.
Photographer, or
mm-hmm.
any other profession that you do?
Okay.
Where, you have to remember, always remember, why did you start?
Yeah.
And what was your goal? Or what's your end goal?
Okay. Well, there's this new wave of, you know, celebrities, apparently. They're called socialites. So, I don't know. I actually don't know the standard definition of a socialite. What would you say? Is a socialite a celebrity or just a wannabe celebrity? Because actually right now, the majority of the so-called celebrities are socialites.
Yeah.
A socialite is someone you pay to make an appearance at your function. Mm-hmm. So they are there to attract crowds because mm-hmm. people want to see them, people want to interact with them, mm-hmm. people want to take photos with them. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they get out of hand, they become rude, they become bossy, they have demands that you can't really understand. Such
they get out of control.
Just, I don't get it.
Yeah. what do you think? Because especially look at social media.
Yeah.
Yes, I understand there's that type of social life. Mm-hmm. You know, let's say, for example, if using an example of the Western world, like Kim Kardashian, you know, go to a party, make an appearance. But African social life. I'm not quite sure about that. So, what do you think of that?
I think African socialites are people who've not done anything in particular, but just happen to be famous.
Why are they famous in the first place?
For a large following. Because you see, even on Instagram, there are people who are just, they have a large following and they are used to promote events. Mm-hmm. So like if I have let's say for example, 1 million+ followers mm-hmm. and someone will come and approach me and be like, okay, you know, promote my event on your page or something. Yeah. So, you know, you become famous, and you know, there's nothing really that there's you've nothing. Done. Yeah.
Well, I'm going to address the elephant in the room, which is how do you get that following? For example, like let's say there's this chick and then she has like 1 million followers on Instagram. How did she get there? Was it because, you know, she has a good cause, you know, probably she's fighting global warming, or, you know, she's donating, you know, money. How did she get there, or how did he get there? Because, you know, right now we also have no...
Oh, the reality on the ground is, as you said, the half-nude photos.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, you shy about talking about
sexy pics, you know, the controversy.
The controversy.
Let's talk. Yeah, let's just say it's the controversy. Yeah. That's how you get there.
I think we can do more. And okay, we've identified the issue here. Is like our celebrities aren't good role models, and they're doing things which are far-fetched, far beyond their means. Even living extravagant lives, which they can't afford. Yeah. That's why you hear a celebrity god broke your life. Really? How? And so, that being the issue, what solutions would you offer? You know, what solutions would you suggest? We can talk about this situation.
I think I like what Carlos said before. Mm-hmm. Know why you're there. Mm-hmm. Know why you got there. Mm-hmm. Because if you went there for the money, obviously you're going to get carried away.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So I think I look at your passion.
Yeah.
Why am I doing this?
Yeah.
And for those who are celebrities by doing nothing, I don't know what solution you can give to them. Yeah. But
just keep hustling.
keep your hustle. Yeah. Do what you have to do, but don't go overboard.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just keep it simple.
Yeah. Your thoughts? Mr. Carlos?
I think it's just basically why are you here.
Why are you here?
Just ask yourself why are you here.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess.
I think, I also think it's our celebrities, you know, especially those in the entertainment industry, should, you know, attach themselves to certain positive projects, you know, like, you know, be a voice, you know, of certain things, like, you know, probably do donations or do something about climate change or do something positive, not always do negative things, because at the end of the day, people out there are, you know, looking up to them. And sometimes you don't have to be controversial to stay relevant, you know, I don't have to do this and that. So I think they have a very big challenge which they should address to be positive agents of positivity in our society, because right now our society is full of negative stuff, and it's high time we do positive things. And I think that's about it. Any NBPS you'd like to add?
I'd say attach yourself to a mentor, because a mentor is the only person who can tell you, okay, you started well, but you're going off course.
You need to
go back
very important
where
you
are.
Yeah.
So mentors are the greatest source of inspiration and knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
So just find a mentor. Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Sense the Podcast. I'm Carlos Lawson.
And I'm Saitabao Kaiyare.
And I'm Anastacia Waweru.
Every episode, every Wednesday, YouTube, SoundCloud. Like us on Facebook. Twitter. Yeah, it's been fun.
It's been real.
Yeah, see you next week.
Peace.
Nailed it.